sharing some precious carbon. That's really important. So thanks for doing it. Yeah. And, it's okay to have a little time to collect our thoughts. This is there's a lot to think about. So welcome, all of you. Hope you can all hear me back there. No mic. I said just use my church voice, so here it is. I'm Michael Kurtz. I'm the pastor at First Student Church. It's been a real privilege to know, have known Jerry for almost the entire time, I think, that I've been at First Student Church, which is 22 years, so it's a long time, and a real pleasure to have a long association with Kim's family. It is lovely to be here with you today. There's a lot to give thanks for, and that is always a great thing. When you have lots to give thanks for, especially in the context of this close, loving family, you know, that is a good thing. I know that Jerry's death was sooner than what everybody was expecting, and that is really hard. So there's lots to grieve, but there's also lots to give thanks for, and that's what we're hearing. There is lots to celebrate. Every time that I was able to be with Jerry, it was a pleasure, right? It was a privilege. I'm going to say a little bit more about that later, but what a lovely person to give thanks for. And what a nice close family she had to support her. So I'm really grateful to be here. It's good to be together in this way, and it's good that we're being recorded so that this can be shared with lots of other people. So welcome to all of you. This is a nice space to be in. It's no longer, you know, super hot, so that's good. Three people near the fire. Thanks for turning that off. That's good. I hope everybody's comfortable. This is a nice room, and I'm glad we're here. So welcome. We are gathered to worship. We're gathered to proclaim Christ crucified and risen. We're gathered to remember before God our sister Jerry. We're here to give thanks for her life. We're here to commend her to God's care. And we're here to comfort one another in our grief. We have many reasons to gather on this day, and they are all good and life-giving ones. So welcome to all of you. Grace and peace be with you all. All who are baptized into Christ have put on Christ. And in her baptism, Jerry was clothed with in the day of Christ's coming, she will be clothed with glory. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Jerry, and we thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Well, we have some time for remembering and for sharing memories and stories, and I know there are a few people who will speak, but I think if there's anybody who'd like to speak, you're welcome to come forward and say a few words in memory of Jerry, perhaps some of your grandchildren, or niece, or nephew. So if you'd like to come forward, feel free at this time, and if not, that's okay. We have people who are going to come and speak. You still have time to think about it, but I would like to invite some to come forward. We're going to go in order of age, I understand, so please come forward.
Thank you very much. I'd be so happy and so pleased to see all of your family here today. Well, what we would all like here today is to have more time. Another minute, another hour, another day with you. We know that it can't be us by surprise. I would like to think that we, your family, are in pretty good shape when you left us as suddenly as you did. And most importantly, you didn't suffer. That gives us all great comfort, knowing that and the fact that you and Dad are together once more. I want to thank you for all of you who've taught me over the years, the life lessons that have enabled me to be successful in all aspects of my life and our lives as well. You have left us with wonderful memories, love of family, and humbleness that will endure within all of us. Your hardworking nature, caring for family above all, are some of your most wonderful kind attributes. as for memories, you know, there's just so many, you know, just so many wonderful memories and stories from long ago. The only thing I would take from this is I only want one that I can be as vivid in my recall when I'm at your age as you are. Mom, well, we will miss you and think of you often with a smile on our faces, knowing that you are safe and comfortable and no longer in pain. But I can only just say for myself that you know, all of us have had our daily telephone calls with Mom, but you know, my own memories are, you know, she'd call and she'd go, "Hi, how's my girl?" And you know, we'd carry on, and "How's our little princess?" And yada yada yada, and then she'd finish off with, "And I love you." And I'm gonna miss that. And I don't want to end this, but I need to, and I need to say, Mom, I love you, we love you, and we just had wonderful memories while you were with us. Just too soon. Thank you.
Times, and that is what I will hold on forever in my heart. It will not
that you are not, again, are not a phone call away. I will miss our talks and the advice you had. You always knew what to say. I will continue to parent the same with my boys with much love and patience that you gave me. Thank you for being my mom. You're forever in my heart, and I love you more. Thank you. Teach others how I wanted to be treated. You put up with all my crap when I was younger. All those times I fought and I didn't want to wear a snowsuit or when I didn't want to eat food. You were patient with me. I remember the day you said to me, "You don't have to call me Mom. Just don't call me Mrs. McDonald." And from that day, I called you Mom. You were there when my mom, birth mom, died. And I'll never forget that. You've been a great lady. I haven't met anyone like you yet. I love you, Mom.
Clearly, you're all five of the same person, right? But there's so much consistency in everything that you say. And, you know, when I was listening to you, I just thought, you know, every life has the potential to be amazing, right? Like, you know, in some ways, Mom was, you lived a fairly quiet life, but it was a hardworking life, and a life filled with love and compassion and kindness. And every life can be that, right? And it has a huge effect. So many people. So I'm really grateful to hear everything that you said. Rob, would you like to come say a few words?
Sure.
Thanks everybody for being here. It's nice to see you here going home. So everybody thinks they have the best mom. I can attest we have the best mom. Our mom made sacrifices for us to give us a better life. The mom and dad brought up five kids working at local Woolworths, Walmart, and CP Rail. Our mom was a courageous lady. Despite her shyness, she didn't let us stop her for providing for her family. She's also very brave when she's dealing with her cancer. She never wanted to let on how much she was suffering to protect us. If you're going this way, you would start a story in the middle and expect everybody to know what you're talking about. Although I found that confusing and frustrating, I'd give anything for you if you tell those stories again. I'd like to give thanks to our moms for helping me. The person I have today, you also have a question you for us. You disciplined me when you did it. You checked on me when I was ill. You listened to me when I was ill. I had a problem. You hit us with your hugs. You showed me how much you cared for me. Mom and I would often talk on the phones before bedtime. She would end her phone conversation with how to eat sleep. Mm-hmm. Now it's my turn. So I'm having good sleep. Thank you.
That was wonderful. Perfect. Thank you very much, Ron. Thanks, everybody. It's so wonderful to hear that word. Just thank you, Mom. Right? So much to you, thanks. And that's what we're here to do. We're also here to have, you know, hear some words of comfort, right? And to be comforted. No loving act is ever wasted in God's economy, right? The love that Jerry shared, that does not die. And that is something important to remember. It's also important to remember that you're not alone in this. Some of the greatest and maybe most well-known words in Scripture are very, very old, but they're from the 23rd Psalm, The Lord is My Shepherd. And I think there is a reason why this is so popular. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures, and he leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. With your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely, goodness and mercy shall pursue me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In the New Testament, the greatest hits today of the Bible. That was the greatest hit of the Old Testament, maybe. The greatest hit of the New Testament, probably 1 Corinthians 13, where Paul speaks about love and the gift of love. Surprisingly, Paul doesn't speak that often about love, but when he does, it's in a very impressive way, as here. Because he knows that love never fails. Never. And I think Jerry knew that. And that is the key to a life well lived. Now writes Paul, I will show you a way without compare. What if I could speak all languages of humans and even of angels? If I did not love others, I would be nothing more than a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. What if I could prophesy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge? And what if I had faith that moved mountains? I would be nothing unless I loved others. What if I gave away all that I owned and let myself be burned alive? I would gain nothing unless I loved others. Love waits patiently, and love acts with kindness. Love does not envy, nor does love boast or puff itself up. Love does not dishonor others. Love does not seek its own benefit, nor is love easily angered. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love does not rejoice in injustice, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and it endures all things. Love never fails. Prophecies will cease. Tongues will become silent. All we know will be forgotten. In any case, we don't know everything, and our prophecies don't tell us everything. But When fulfillment comes, everything partial will fade away. When I was a child, I talked, thought, and reasoned like a child. But when I grew up, I put the ways of the child behind me. At this point, we see only imperfectly, like looking into a very cloudy mirror. But someday, we will see clearly, as if we are face to face. At this point, we don't know everything, but someday we will. Just as God completely knows us right now. In the meantime, three things are truly enduring: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. Well, grace to you and peace from the one who is and who was and who is to come. Amen. Well, Jerry was a person of love. We heard that over and over. And the beautiful memories of her that we just heard. And that love expressed itself in her life in many ways. In her work life, which was not easy, but in which she worked hard to earn a living and provide for her family. Love expressed itself in her marriage, her good marriage to Ed. Love expressed itself in her humility, in her kindness, and in her quiet-spoken but straight-shooting sociability. It expressed itself in putting others before herself and in not wanting anyone to worry about her. As I heard, in her mind, it was her job to be the one doing the worry. Above all, her love expressed itself in the circle of her family, in the people who are gathered here today. I think Jerry loved her family above all. Family was very important to her. And as I heard, she was likely happiest when she was with her family. It is true that her life was never really easy, so it's a good thing that she was a strong person. But then, too, it's a good thing that she had a really good support system throughout her life. Her parents in the first place, her kids, grandchildren, and extended family in the second place. Jerry loved for sure, but in turn, she herself was also deeply loved and cherished. So there is a great deal to give thanks for today. We gather today to just say thank you to God for the gift of this person in our lives, for the person she was, for the marriage she had, for the family she cared for, and the life that she led. We give thanks, too, for all the care and all the love that she received from her family. A love that did bring joy and meaning to her life. As we commend Jerry into the love of God on this day, we say thank you. And we ask God to hold her with a love that will keep her safe for us until the day of resurrection. Paul reminds us really beautifully that love is the biggest, most enduring, most eternal thing in the universe. Love is something that never fails. Love is something that will endure long after mountains crumble and the seas dry up. Love is the one thing that in the universe that shares in the quality of the eternal. Love never ends. All our mistakes, failures, shame, those things will come to an end. These things are not forever. These things do not define. And all the love you ever received, and all the love you ever given, that will remain. And that is a very, very comforting thought. When the pandemic began 2 years ago, I wrote this. It's still on our website. Encourage one another. Pray for one another. Be of good courage. God's loving presence was here long before the universe was created. And it will be here long after we are gone. We are part of a much larger story of God's plan to bring healing, wellness, and life to a world that God dearly loves. This is the story that Jerry was baptized into all those years ago. And this is the story she found her own place and her own role in, the story of God's unending desire to bring healing, restoration, and reconciliation of this world. Jerry loved, And she made sure to tell people that. And more than that, she showed it through her actions. And that is really something to be grateful for. So let us not finish saying thank you on this day for Jerry's life. Let us honor her in life by continuing to care for each other, and let us now commend her into a love that never ends, confident that on the day of resurrection, only love will remain when we are gathered together in an eternal embrace of care and of life. Amen. Jesus, firstborn of creation, who raised the dead, give our sister Jerry fullness of life. Jesus, wellspring of life, you washed our sister Jerry in baptism and anointed her with the Holy Spirit. Give her communion with all your saints. Jesus, bright morning star, comfort us in our sorrows at the death of Jerry. Let trust be our consolation and fullness of life our hope. God of all grace, we give you thanks, because by his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection opened the kingdom of heaven to all. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Gracious and loving God, together with Jerry and Ed and all those near and dear to us who have died in you, remember us all in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us now commend Jerry to the mercy of God, who is our Maker and our Redeemer.
Bye.
Into your hands, merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Jerry. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a lamb of your own flock and a sheep of your own fold. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. May the Lord bless her and keep her. May the Lord's face shine on her with grace and mercy. May the Lord look upon her with favor and grant her peace. Amen. So I think before the final prayer and blessing, we can place the urn there.